Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to see or discuss the numerical on non-flow process part 5. Okay, this is the 5th video on this point. Also go through all the previous 4 videos. We are going to discuss various numerical on non-flow process, the application of first law of thermodynamics. Let's start with today's numerical. A 2 kg of an ideal gas is compressed adiabatically. So the process is adiabatic process. Okay, all the previous videos we are going to discuss the isochoric, isothermal, isobaric process. Now we discuss the adiabatic process in today's video. From pressure 100 kilopascal and the temperature 220 Kelvin and the final pressure is 400 kilopascal. So they given mass, initial pressure, final pressure, initial temperature. Okay, and they are going to calculate initial volume V1, then final volume and temperature. Final volume and temperature, work performed, heat added or rejected. We find out from that sign that either heat is added or rejected, the change in internal energy. Okay, for adiabatic index, you always remember we must first find out that adiabatic index. Okay, this is the ratio of Cp upon Cv. In numerical, they given value of Cp and Cv. Okay, before starting this numerical, you first calculate the adiabatic index. Okay, calculated. Before calculating that adiabatic index, they ask initial volume V1. Okay, for calculating initial volume, I use the general characteristic gas equation. P1 V1 is equal to mR T1. P1 is with us, mass they given, T1 is with us. The unknown is now V1 and R. First calculate R by the relation, that is the Cp minus Cv is equal to R. Then we calculate V1, put the values, we get volume around 1.29 meter cube. Okay, where put the value of R is always remember in joule per kg Kelvin. Okay, and because we put the pressure in Newton per meter square, you see here that 100 pressure P1 is equal to 100 kilopascal. We are going to convert 100 into 10 raised to 3 Pascal, and we know that 1 Pascal is equal to 1 Newton per meter square. So our pressure in Newton per meter square. So the volume is also meter cube, and so that value of R in joule per kg Kelvin. After calculating V1, we calculate the adiabatic index. Okay, before solving the numerical, we always keep in mind these 3 relations. PV relation, TV relation and TP relation. For PV relation, the rest power is gamma. For TV, gamma minus 1, and for TP, gamma minus 1 upon gamma. This rest power is going to modify. So remember this sequence same, PV relation, TV and TP relation. Apply the first relation for adiabatic process. Why I'm going to prefer PV relation? Because for PV relation, we know the both the pressure is with us, one volume is with us, and they ask final volume. So using this relation, okay, before how to remember this relation, okay, in PV I make cross sign, for TV also make cross sign, and TP is the equal sign. Okay, why I'm preferring this sign? Okay, take example of PV relation. Now I write such a way that suppose I'm taking ratio of P2 upon P1, okay, is equal to where I'm making cross sign, what it's taking reciprocal of now volume ratio, like 2 upon 1, 9 volume is V1 upon V2 and the rest to gamma. Similarly for TV relation and for TP I am making equal sign. What it indicates when taking ratio of TP here, T2 upon T1 is equal to P2 upon P1. So I am making that right sign and the rest power is gamma minus 1 upon gamma. Okay, here we see both pressure is with us. Okay, one volume is with us. So we can find out the final volume V2. Okay, how we simplify that gamma when simplify this equation see here, the P2 upon P1 is equal to, okay, that's gamma is in the raised power 1 upon gamma is equal to V1 upon V2. So find out V2, how you find out V2? V2 is equal to now V1 upon the P2 upon P1 1 upon gamma. Okay, if we solve this way, also you can get the same relation. They use P1 V1 raised to gamma is equal to P2 V2 raised to gamma. Okay, we go through this also. This is the same. Or also we remember these three relations. Okay, just cross check these values. I am modified one formula here. Okay, yeah, we just cross check this answer. V1 is 1.29 divided P2 upon P1. So P2 here 400. We either convert or not because the ratio, so we cancel each other. 400 and upon 100. Just I cross check by using this relation. Okay, and the raised to power, K P2 400 upon 100 raised to 1 upon gamma. That is the, we calculate the adiabatic index, the gamma is 1.414 and the answer is 0.483 is the correct. We also go through this relation also, then we get correct answer around 0.4839, that is 0.484. Choice is your. Okay, then again from the characteristics gas equation, we find out the final temperature T2. Work performed, we remember this formula, P1 V1 minus P2 to gamma minus 1, put the values, keep the pressure in Newton per meter square. We get the answer in joule, we have converted into that kilojoule. Okay, what is the minus sign indicates? It is the work done on the system. Okay, the adiabatic compression, we know that there is no heat transfer, so dq is always zero. So the relation is, we know that wq minus w is equal to change in internal energy, and already our answer is minus w, so the change in internal energy is w is equal to w. Okay, hopes you understood this numerical. So we all find out all the unknowns here, just directly put the values and keep remembering the mind the relations. Okay, now let's start with the next numerical. A certain perfect gas contained a perfectly insulated piston cylinder arrangement at 100 kilopascal pressure and 290 Kelvin temperature. When the gas undergoes a non-flow reversible compression process to 500 kilopascal, its temperature rises to 350 Kelvin. Okay, there is one piston cylinder arrangement. Okay, initially they told that all are perfectly insulated. So the, again, adiabatic process, the piston cylinder all are perfectly insulated. Initial pressure before applying is 100 kilopascal, and the initial temperature, they also given initial temperature T1 is 290 Kelvin. See here. Okay, during compression, at the end of compression, what is the final pressure? P2 500 kilopascal. And the final temperature T2 during the compression, pressure is also goes on increases, temperature also increases, the temperature is rise up to 350 Kelvin. So with us P1 T1 and P2 T2, if the work done on the gas during the compression process is 50 kilojoule per kg, so it is the, we going to work, applying work, that is the compression, so it is the work is done on the system, so negative, they are not directly given, mention the work is done on the system. This is the 50 kilojoule, so I am right 15 to 10 raised to 3 joule per kg, per kg, so this mass is 1 kg. Evaluate adiabatic exponent, that is they have to find, going to find out the adiabatic exponent, that is the gamma, specific heat at constant volume CV, characteristics gas constant, and the molecular mass of the molecular mass of the gas. So we have to find out value of R and M. Okay, this is the adiabatic process. You know that. So they first find out the adiabatic exponent. For calculating adiabatic exponent, they given the value of P, pressure, and both temperature. So I prefer TP relation. That is the third relation we know in previous video also discussed. We just write PV, TV, and TP. This sequence PV, TV, and TP. Gamma, gamma minus 1 upon gamma. And this is the third relation. I make equal sign. So we find, if you see here, T2 upon T1 is equal to P2 upon P1 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. Both temperature with us, both pressure with us. So simply take a log. So you can find out. Okay, just I solve here. Just take a log on both sides. What happened? Log of T2 upon T1. When you're taking log, that adiabatic component is like that. Log P2 upon P1. Okay, you have to find now the value of adiabatic index. Log T2 upon T1, log P2 upon P1. Okay, taking log, we directly we find the values like one, we find one relation, one equation. If we solve this ratio, we get ratio is like that, 0.1168. So gamma minus 1 is equal to 0.1168 gamma. Okay, if we take gamma terms on one side, we make common gamma, then we get the value of adiabatic index is around 1.13. okay, then very simple, the adiabatic process, the Q is again 0, work done is given. I keeping minus because work done on the system. Find we can change in internal energy. From the change in internal energy, M is we taking 1. Okay, we find both temperatures with us, so we can find out the specific heat. Okay, and we know the one relation of the CV. CV is equal to gamma minus 1 upon R. So first we calculate the CV in the previous stage. Gamma is with us, we can find out the value of R also. And you know the another relation, RV is equal to MR. Then you know the gas constant, keeping the values always 8.314. Okay, you just find out the value of M now. So RU divided R, we can get M. So that molecular mass or that unknown mass, the molecular mass is around 75.65. This is the straightforward. If you see the adiabatic process, very simple. Just you need to find out the which relation is going to prefer. This is very again numerical, same number, simple numerical. Now we move further. The last numerical is a 0.5 kg of an ideal gas expands adiabatically until its pressure is halved. Okay, during the expansion of the gas, does 30 kilojoule of external work and temperature falls. The expansion process. Okay, so that pressure is going to reduce, you know, expansion, drop in the pressure. Okay, 0.5 kg, the mass is given, 0.5 kg expand adiabatically, so adiabatic process is there until its pressure is halved. So P2 is equal to, there is given one relation, so P2 is equal to halved, so P1 upon 2. Okay, of P1, so we get relation 1, P2 is equal to P1 of 2. Then during the expansion, okay, does gas, the 30 kilojoule of external work. So the work done by the system is positive 13 to 10 raised to 3 joule. And temperature falls from T1 is 500 Kelvin and T2 is 410 Kelvin. This is a given data. Make calculation for adiabatic exponent, that is the gamma. Okay, so they also again they give both temperatures, if you see, and the both pressure. Okay, we take again log, P2 is equal to P1 by 2, the given one relation, correct? Just simply solve this as we also solved in previous numerical also, that is the adiabatic index. For the adiabatic process, dq is again 0. Work is done on the system. Okay. Okay, is it W2? Is we get one relation from this equation? Dq is 0. So work done is equal to minus change in internal energy. Work done is with us 30 kilojoule. Okay. The change in internal energy is MCV delta T. So find out the CP. First we calculate the CV from this relation, and from the gas constant we know the relation now. This is similar to the previous numerical, same as it is. Okay, then if I using that UM is with us, DT is with us, unknown is CV. First let's find out CV here and use the relation. R is equal to CV in bracket gamma minus 1. Or we also remember such a way that CV is equal to R upon gamma minus 1. Before starting all the numericals, I'm making the one table, or this the supportive equations we need. I also discuss, go through the previous videos, we get an idea. Okay, the last numerical. A 3 kg of air kept in absolute pressure of 100 kilopascal and temperature of 300 Kelvin is compressed polytropically. Okay, this is a polytropic process. Okay, where the, if you see the adiabatic index for that process is a constant. Now from that index we are going to find out the either process is adiabatic, either process is isothermal, either process isobaric. There is a that exponential, from the exponential value we are going to decide which process carrying out. So we call it a polytropic process. There is a, I am keeping one example for that reference, a 3 kg of air. So mass is air, absolute pressure P1 and the temperature T1, compression process there until pressure is and temperature becomes, there is a P2 and T2. So the temperature goes on increases 300 to 500 and pressure also increases because of compression process, 100 to 1500. Evaluate polytropic exponent, final volume and the work of compression and heat interaction. Okay, take gas constant R, the given down R. There's no need to calculate now CV and all the things. First find out the polytropic index, both temperature with us, both pressure with us. Take a log, find out the value of N. Then using the basic relation, characteristic gas equation PV is equal to MRT, find V1, V2. Why decide for calculate V1, V2? Because they ask work of compression. And the formula is P1 V1 minus P2 V2 upon N minus 1. N is with us. The volume is not mentioned. The given hint, both temperature R, M are given. From you calculate the work done. Okay, the answer is negative. So what is indicates the compression process. Okay, so during compression work is done on the system. So it must be negative. The negative side indicates the work has done on the gas. Now CV is equal to R upon gamma minus 1. Okay. They have found out the CV here because they also ask the change in internal energy. Okay. For that purpose, they found out the CV. Okay. MCV delta T. If you see that polytropic index N1.23. Okay. So here put the value, we not put the value here 1.4. Okay, this is the printing mistake. To find out the, keep the values, that is the value of that index N, what will be value is there. Then find out the MCV delta T, we can get the change in internal energy. Okay, for non-flow energy equation, now work is with us, change in internal energy is with us. So the Q is around minus 318.2 kilojoule. Okay, the negative sign indicates the heat is rejected. Okay, the alternative method is there here for calculating that Q, but we go through that basic fundamental equation only. This is very simple as compared to the alternative. We need to again remember this one formula. Okay, there is no need. We just go to directly here. So hopes you understood all the numericals on this whole process. go through the also previous videos, and hopes you can clear all the variety of types of numerical I'm going to cover, and hopes you understood. Thank you.